In this video, we're going to be talking about everything you need to know to get started creating custom characters in Roblox, and at the end, we'll walk through the flow of how to create them yourself. Avatar characters are customizable character models that wear accessories and clothing and can interact with the environment and other users. All avatar character models are made of the same things that we'll call components, and we're going to go ahead and break those up into two categories, rendered and non-rendered. The rendered components are the part of the character you can see, like the body parts and the textures. There are 15 total body part meshes that make up the physical geometry of a character model. This includes the head, lower and upper torso, and pieces for each leg and arm. Textures are 2D images that define the surface skin of your character's look. If you use transparency in your textures, you can see the underlying part color, which lets you create user-customizable skin tones. The non-rendered components include the rigging armature, facial animation data, cage meshes, and attachment points. The rigging armature allows the body parts to properly connect with each other to enable movement and animation through a standardized skeleton. The facial animation data allows avatars to express virtually all types of facial expressions for chatting and socializing. The cage meshes set the outer boundary of the character. This defines a surface where clothing and other layerable items can wrap and stretch over. And lastly, attachment points define where rigid accessories are able to attach to a character. Now that you know what components you need in order to make a custom character, let's walk through a generalized common flow of how to create one from scratch. Just as a forewarning, creating a character from scratch can take industry professionals several weeks or months to create, test, and iterate. Roblox is continuing to create new features and tools to help automate and simplify this process, such as the Avatar Auto Setup tool that can automatically generate most of your non-rendered components for you. First, start by modeling your character in a third-party software like Blender and Maya, keeping in mind your body sizing and scale. After you're done modeling, it's time to move on to texturing. Textures, especially modern PBR textures, are often created using additional software, such as Substance Painter. With your model sculpted and textured, it's time to do the rigging and skinning, which you'll do separately for the head and body. Rigging is the act of connecting an internal skeleton to your mesh to allow it to move, and skinning is the act of telling those bones how to organically move and bend with the surrounding geometry through a process called weight painting. Next up, it's time to create and map the facial poses of your character to allow it to make different facial expressions. The last step of the creation process is to modify your character's body caging. Caging refers to fitting an invisible surface to your character model to define how other assets, like clothing, interact with your character. Roblox provides cage meshes that you must use to ensure that all clothes and characters are compatible with each other. When you're happy with how your character looks in your third-party tool, it's time to export it and then import it into Studio. Make sure to follow the export instructions for characters. This can be slightly different depending on the modeling software you're using. Then use Studio's 3D importer to import the model file into Studio. Your 3D file imports as a model object containing your mesh parts. Once inside Studio, it's critically important to test your avatar using the Avatar Setup tool or with Roblox's Avatar Test Place. Playtest your characters to make sure all your animations, clothes, custom skin tones, and everything else works like you expect. Thanks for watching! We hope you found that helpful. For more information about any of these steps and to learn about them in more detail, be sure to check out the resources in the description.